Welcome back to the web series of cardiovascular system. Pericarditis. Pericarditis is a condition caused by inflammation of the pericardial sac, which may occur on an acute basis. Etiology. Idiopathic. Infectious causes: viral infection, bacterial infection and fungal infection. Non-infectious causes: uremia, neoplasm, trauma, myocardial infarction. Autoimmune or hypersensitivity causes: Dressler syndrome, rheumatic fever and rheumatoid arthritis. Pathophysiology of disorders of pericardium: due to the etiological factors, inflammatory response occurs. Influx of neutrophils and other chemical mediators occurs. It leads to change in the permeability of pericardial vascularity. Pericardial inflammation and edema occurs. It leads to restriction of heart motion and pain with breathing. Clinical manifestations: chest pain, located beneath the clavicle, in the neck or in the left scapular region. Mild fever, dyspnea and other signs and symptoms of heart failure may occur as a result of pericardial compression. Assessment and diagnostic findings: patient history, physical examination, signs of pericardial friction, rub on auscultation. 12 lead ECG detects ST changes. Chest X-ray, echocardiogram. Lab investigation include elevated WBC, C-reactive protein and ESR. Pericardial biopsy. Management of pericarditis: identifying, treating the underlying problems. Patient is placed on bed rest. Pericardiosynthesis, procedure in which the pericardial fluid is removed. Antibiotic therapy. Analgesics and NSAIDs such as aspirin or ibuprofen. Corticosteroids. Nursing management of pericarditis: explain every procedure to the patient in order to get consent, cooperation and array anxiety. Position patient in semi-Fowler's to relieve pain and allow expansion of chest for effective breathing. Explain the pathophysiology to the patient. Encourage gradual increase activity. Monitor vital signs closely to detect infections. Nursing diagnosis of pericarditis: ineffective breathing pattern related to chest pain. Altered thermoregulation, hypothermia related to infection. Altered comfort pain related to inflammation of the pericardium. Risk for cardiogenic shock related to decreased cardiac output. Ineffective tissue perfusion related to decreased blood flow. Complications: arrhythmias. It may be due to irritation of the sinus node, which is located close to the parietal pericardium. Pericardial effusion: accumulation of fluid within pericardial sac is called pericardial effusion. Cardiac tamponade: it develops as the pericardial effusion increases in size, compensatory mechanism ultimately fail to decrease the cardiac output.